हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक अगेन। आई होप यू आर क्लियर विद द प्रीवियस वीडियो रिगार्डिंग फाइंडिंग आउट द यूनिट वेट्स ऑफ डिफरेंट डायमीटर्स ऑफ बार्स फॉर अ गिवन फार्मूला, दैट इज डी स्क्वायर बाय 162। रिमेंबर दैट फार्मूला एंड जस्ट सब्स्टिट्यूट द वैल्यूज ऑफ डिफरेंट डायमीटर बार्स, यू गेट द यूनिट वेट ऑफ स्टील। सो मूविंग ऑन टू नेक्स्ट, विल कैलकुलेट वॉट इज अ बार बाइंडिंग शेड्यूल फॉर द गिवन स्लैब हियर। एज यू कैन सी, he says prepare a detailed estimate of RCC roof slab of 3 meter clear span and 6 meter long from a given drawing. RCC work including centering and shuttering and steel reinforcement in detail shall be taken separately. Also prepare a schedule of bars. Okay, so from the cross section of the slab you can see the clear span of the slab is 3 meters and bearing on either side are 15 centimeter. So the bent up for a bar is taken from the face at a distance of 50 cm on both sides. The main steel is 12 mm diameter bar with 12 cm center to center, and distribution steel is 6 mm diameter with 18 cm center to center. Right? Okay. So the slab thickness is given as 12 cm thick. Now if you see the plan, the arrangement of bars. Okay, let's start from here. Bearing is 15 cm. This is the outer edge of the slab. Length of the slab in longer direction is 6 meter clear and shorter direction is 3 meter clear. So from this vertical lines, what you see, these are bars of 6 mm dia, 18 cm center to center, means these bars are distribution bars, and the horizontal lines what you see are main bars. Now regarding this main bars, from one bar to one bar it is 12 cm. Now these bars are alternately bent, means what, one bar is running straight, the other bar immediately placed next to that is bent up, means up till here it is straight and this dotted line indicates it is going up like this and it is bent. So what is the center to center distance between bent up bar and bent up bar? It is 24 cm. Right, and what is the distance between straight bar and straight bar? It is 24 cm, double. So when you are calculating the number of bars required for the slab, okay, we'll come to that later. I hope you are clear with the drawing given here. Okay, moving on to next, the calculation part. In calculation part, firstly, prepare a table like this, right? The first quantities he has told, you have to also calculate what is a quantity for shuttering. Shuttering is nothing but the formwork that is provided in terms of plywood, which forms the exact shape of any particular RCC member. That is, they use a plywoods before they pour a concrete. That is what is shuttering and shuntering, right? So first quantity, RCC work specification given is 1:2:3 excluding steel and its bending, but including centering and shuttering and binding steel. Centering and shuttering, this means the skeleton of the steel, and shuttering is the plywood work that is done before pouring a concrete. Now we are dealing with only one slab member, so quantity will be one. Now what is the overall shuttering required? Now you see here, this is 3 meter, this is 6 meter, is this, 3 meter is this. This is clear span, this is clear span, but shuttering is always done with respect to the outdoor distance. So clear span is 3, so bearing is what, 15-15 on both sides. So total shuttering work will be what, 3.3. similarly here, bearing is 15, so it will be 6.3. so what will be the length of shuttering? It is 6.3 and width is 3.3. what is depth of concrete or depth of slab? It is 0.12. the depth of the slab given is 0.12, so you can see here. So clear span for slab is 3 meters and bearing is 15-15. So you are going to provide that shuttering from here to here, so 3.3, and similarly length 6 meter is clear, so bearing here 15 15, so 6.3, and depth of slab is 12 centimeter. So your overall length will be what? This is your overall length. Since you are providing shuttering, so there are no deductions for this. There are no deductions. Okay. Immediately after you calculate shuttering, coming to the calculation of steel, because we are dealing with bar bending schedule. Next, steel bars including bending, mild steel in RCC work, main bars. Now in slab, one is this kind of bar. One bar runs full from slab to slab. The other bar immediately after this will run like this. Right? So the main bars, again you have to classify them into two parts. Main bars which are running straight, so I'll call them as straight bars, and bent up bars. Now how do you calculate the number of bars required for main bars? Number of bars required for main bars is calculated by first calculating what is the length of the main bar. If you look from the figure, what will be the length of main bar? So main bar is placed horizontal, so we know that the clear span is 3 meter and bearing on either side is what? 15 and 15. So total length, I'll write it as what? Calculate length of one bar, I'll write 3.3 is out to out. Then, so bar is not exactly touching this concrete face, we have to give some covering. So covering is 40 mm for both sides, so that will be two covers are minus two covers plus. So bar is not straight, it goes like this and it bends, it takes a bend. So you should know what is length of one hook. So length of one hook is taken as 9 times the diameter. So here one hook is 9 times the diameter. So total will be 18. So we are adding two hooks. So out to out distance is 3.3 minus two covers from both sides. This is, I'll explain, 3 meter plus 0.15 plus 0.15, 3.3 minus cover from both sides plus the bent that is taking. Can you see the bend here? So that is taken as 9 times D on one side. So those two hooks. So total length will be what? 3.3 minus 0.08, because cover is taken as 4 centimeter, plus two hooks is what? 18 into diameter of bar is 0.012. So you get bar length as 3.44 meter. So this 3.44 meter is one bar length. So length of one bar required is how much? 3.44. So like this 3.44 meter length bar, How many such bars we require? So to calculate how many such bars are required, main bars are placed like this, but they are placed along what length? They are placed along 6 meter span. Now to calculate the number of bars, I know what is the total length from this part to this part. It is 6 meters clear span plus 15 on one side. So numbers calculated, numbers is equal to 6.3 is out to out distance of the slab, because bars are placed along the 6 meter length. So 6.3 minus, I'll deduct two covers. So cover is 4 centimeter on one side, so two covers will be deducted, so that will be 0.08, right? 0.08 divided by, what is the spacing of bars? It is 24 centimeter, means what? 0.24 plus 1. So whatever you get, so 6.3 is the length minus this, so this is the total length. So center to center distance of one bar is 0.24, so if you divide with the total length, you will get number of bars, add 1 to that. So doing all that, you will get number of bars as 27. So number of straight bars required for a particular slab is how many? 27 bars. Each bar is having what length? 3.44. Now similarly calculate what is the number of bars required for bent up. So bent up bars, as you can see, are also placed along 6 meter length. So that will be what numbers is equal to 6.3 minus 0.8, again same. Now this is 0.24. Don't add plus 1 here, because already one straight bar, one alternate bar, one straight bar, one alternate bar, ultimately will end up with what? Straight bar, because you start with straight bar, you end up with straight bar. So bent up bar will be 1 minus the straight bar, so do not add plus 1 to this. So calculating this, you will get number of bars as 26, and also the length of this bar will also what? 3.44. Is it? So length of bent up bar will be 3.44 plus 3.44 plus, you have to add one depth of two bent ups. So how do you calculate that? Okay, so you can see that from this face of, this is the concrete face like this, a bar is bent like this, right? And there is one bar like this. This outer bar is how much? 12 centimeter. This you take as 2 centimeter cover, this you take as 2 centimeter cover. What is this total depth? So this is total depth is 8 cm. 12 minus 2, 10, 10 minus 2, 8. So since this is 45 degrees, so assume this extra quantity as one depth. So this will be what? 3.44 plus add one depth to this, 8 centimeter. So this will be your total length of bent up bars. Right? This will be your total length of bent up bars. After doing this, now we calculated what are the number of bars required for 12 mm. Now we'll calculate what are the number of bars required for distribution. Now how is the placing of distribution bar? So you can see from the figure, distribution bars are placed vertical. They are placed along what length? They are placed along 3 meter span. So 3 meter span means what? 3 meter span, but the problem here is, you can see there are certain number of bars before the bar has actually bent. Right, we need to calculate what are those bars. What are those bars? Now to calculate that, I should know what is this length. I should know what is this length. So number of bars, so before that we'll calculate what is the length of one particular bar. So This distribution bar length will be what? It is this. It is lying complete span for 6 meter length. But it is placing is along what? 3 meter length. So length of one bar will be with respect to this. Spacing will be with respect to 3 meter. So out-to-out distance is what? 6 plus 0.15 plus 0.15. So length calculation is 6.3 minus 0.08, because out-to-out distance minus cover plus 18 into 0.06. 18 times diameter is a hook. So you'll get 6.33 meter. So we calculated what is length of one bar, distribution bar. Now number of bars. Now what we'll do is we'll divide that. So total span here is what? 3 meter. Right? So we'll divide them as distribution steel in central, mid span. Central mid span. So 3 meter is clear. 50 50, so 3 meter minus 0.5 meter minus 0.5 meter, it will be what? 2 meter. So this length is what? 2 meters. So 2 meter divided by what is spacing of one bar? It is 0.18 plus 1, so you get 12 numbers. So how many bars in mid span? 12 numbers of bars. Now from the figure you can see, so leaving these bars, we calculated these bars, these are 12 numbers. Now excluding those, how many bars are on this side, how many bars on this side at bottom and top, we need to calculate. Now bottom bars, two sides, both sides, how many bars? So to calculate that, how many bars, so we calculated for 2 meter length, it is how many bars? 12 numbers. Now out of 3 meters we already calculated for 2 meters. So for 2 meter we already calculated number of bars are 12 numbers. So if I calculate what are the number of bars for 3 meters, so 3 meters is clear span. If I divide that with the spacing, I'll get number of bars. So plus 1 will be what? 18 numbers of bars. So out of 18, already 12 are gone. So remaining how many bars? 6 number of bars. 6 number of bars. Now this 6 number of bars I cannot provide on one side, so I should divide them. So I'll divide them into what? 3 numbers of bars, 3 numbers of bars. Left side, right side. So these 3 number of bars are, so those 12 number of bars are placed here and 3 bars are placed here, 3 bars are placed here. So distribution bar is not provided at the top, so we are left with only providing at the corners. So 3 here bottom, 3 here bottom, 3 top, 3 top. So how many bars? So bottom bars will provide 2 sides into 3 bars. 2 sides into 3 bars. So these values I have written here. What is length? 6.33. Similarly, top bars, 2 sides. So again, 2 sides, 3 bars. What is length? 6.33. So after you do this, so after multiplying 27 into 3.44, 26 into this length, you will get the total length of bar required is 184.4 meters. Right? Similarly, by multiplying 12 into this, this into this, and this into this, you will get the total length of bar required is 151.92 meters. After you calculate the total length, immediately draw this. This is a standard way of representing the steel quantity. So what I'll do is, first particulars, main bar, straight, bent up, distribution bars. So main bars are of what categories? They are of 12 mm diameter, and the total length is what? 184. So where should I write that? I should write it in this column. So 184.4. Similarly, distribution steel is of 6 mm diameter. Where should I write that? I should write it at 6 mm diameter. So it is 150, 1.92. So I'll round it off to 152. Right. So total length after doing all this. So total length is how much? 152. 184.4. Then unit weight of 6 mm is what? We have already calculated. It is 0.22. And 12 mm is 0.89. So if you don't remember, do it by this formula, d square by 162, you will get unit weights. So multiply, total length is in meters and unit weight is in kg per meter, so you will get steel in what? Kg. So multiply this and this, multiply this and this, so you will get the steel quantity as 164.12 and this as 197.54. Add both, you will get total quantity of steel. You will get total quantity of steel. Oh, sorry. So this is not 164. This is not 197. So you will get this as 33.42 kgs and this as 164.12 kgs. So adding both, you will get as 197.54. You can round it off to 200 kgs. In short, 2 quintals. 2 quintal of steel is required for this particular slab. Right? Okay. Hope you are clear with the concepts of bar bending schedule. Let us recall once again. First thing, calculate the RCC shuttering work, consider the outdoor dimensions and you will get the volume, so write that quantity. Then for slab, consider straight bars and bent up bars. Center to center between straight bars and straight bar is 24, twice the center distance given. Similarly for bent up, it is twice the distance given. So consider the lengths, calculate number of bars, calculate length of one bar. For distribution, for bent up bar, add one depth. Similarly, you will get what is total length. Calculate what is the total length for 12 mm diameter bar. Go for six distribution bar, central width, bottom and top on the sides. Calculate the total length of bar. After doing this, prepare an abstract sheet like this, where you can differentiate between different diameters. So main bars are of 12 mm, so write what is the total length of main bars in 12 mm column. For distribution, 6 mm bar is there, so write total length here. So that total length you have to multiply with unit weight. So calculation of unit weight is done with d square by 162. Then you will get what is the total weight of steel in kgs. Hope you are clear with the concepts. If you like this video, please hit a like button and support this page. Thank you.